Hi friends, in this tutorial I want to show you how we can create Thiessen polygons for a catchment area. Let us from home draw. I use spline fit. Okay, I create a region or a catchment. That's the region we have. For location frame gauges, I use donut. From draw, donut, choose donut. Inside diameter, I want it so small. Okay, for outside diameter, let be this much. Okay, now I can choose the location. I want to distribute the frame gauges uniformly. One let be in the center. Another one, let be here. Another one here. Okay, I think it is good. Let's name this rain gauges from annotate line. I choose single line. Okay. Specify start point. Here start point and. This is endpoint. Rotation, I don't want any rotation. This one let be A. This one B. This one C. This one D. And this one let be E. Okay. Now we have to connect it. Now we have to connect it, the rain gauges in a way that the connector line should not be intersect each other. This the rain gauge C can be connected for all the other four rain gauges. Okay. This one can be connected for three, the center or ring gauge C and for E, and this one for B also. Now we have to connect B with A, but you can't connect B with E because they intersect, and also we cannot connect D with A because it intersects the line between B and C. Okay, now we can connect A with A. Okay, this time we have to create a perpendicular line on this connector lines. From draw, from line, choose create line perpendicular from point. Okay, I want to first select the line and choose the center. That's the center. I want to the line should be in this distance. Directly program create a perpendicular line. Also, I want another line on this one. Select line. Distance, it should be intersect with the region. Okay, it is good. That's another perpendicular line. For B and D. That's center. Okay. Also, another one. That's the method for creating Thiessen polygons. Also, we have to create perpendicular line on the intermediate connector lines. Okay. Also, this one. We have to have perpendicular line on all the connector lines. Now I want to change the color of this perpendicular line to red or green. First select it. Right click on the lines, properties, color, choose green. Okay. Now select all and from home modify, choose extend. Now I want to extend this one. Okay. Also all perpendicular lines should be extended. Okay. This one also. This one also should be connected till intersected. Now it's intersected. We don't need an more. We don't need more extenders. It has should be intersect. Now, okay. This one should be no. We don't need this one because direct is origin for this one. We need to intersect this one also. Okay, this one also. We have to change the color from white to red because it's a perpendicular line. Okay, I think it's good. Let's change color for this one. Properties. Let be green. Okay. Select all. Home. Modify. Choose trim. Extend. Trim. From this one, I want to trim this one. I don't need. Also, I don't need here this one. I don't need this one. Okay. I don't need this one too. Okay, we have to trim this one. I have to trim this one also. We have to trim this one. Okay, I don't need this one. I don't need this one. We can trim this one also. Don't need this. That is a process. Also, we can trim this one. We don't need this one too. Okay. Let us delete. Now, this area belongs to the station A, and this area belongs to the station D. This circle belongs to the center station, and this area belongs to B, this one for A. And also just write area. For example, I want to find the area for the center one. Okay, here. Enter. The area is 12,740 and perimeter is 441. That's all. I hope it can be helpful. Have a nice time.